हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लासियस मोसोटी इक्वेशन। सो दिस इक्वेशन गिव्स अ रिलेशन बिटवीन द माइक्रोस्कोपिक डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट एंड माइक्रोस्कोपिक पोलराइजेबिलिटी फॉर नॉन पोलर डाइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल्स। नाउ व्हेन दिस नॉन पोलर डाइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल प्लेस्ड इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड द डाइपोल मोमेंट आर इंड्यूस्ड। इफ यू कंसिडर Pi is the induced dipole moment in an atom due to the internal or local field Ei, then we can write the equation Pi is equal to alpha into Ei, where this alpha indicates polarizability of the material. If dielectric materials have n number of molecules per unit volume, then we can write this equation like this. P bar is equal to Pi into capital N. Now here in this equation, we put the value of Pi, that is alpha into Ei. Equation becomes P bar is equal to alpha into Ei into capital N. Okay. Now rearrange this equation like this. Alpha is equal to P bar divided by N into Ei bar. Give equation number one. Now after that, we know that Ei is equal to, value of this Ei is nothing but the E plus P divided by 3 epsilon 0. Now put this value of Ei in equation 1, we get the equation alpha is equal to P bar divided by capital N into in bracket E bar plus P bar divided by 3 epsilon 0, bracket complete, give equation number 2. Now again the polarization term or polarization we can write in terms of the permittivity. So the equation for the polarization P bar is equal to epsilon 0 into in bracket epsilon r minus 1 bracket complete E bar. Now here from this equation we can write the equation for the E bar. E bar is equal to what we get? E bar is equal to P bar divided by this epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1. Give equation number 3. Now put equation 3 in equation 2, or another way, this value of E bar we just put out in equation 2, we get the equation alpha is equal to P bar divided by capital N into in bracket P bar divided by epsilon 0 into epsilon r minus 1 plus P bar divided by 3 epsilon 0. Okay, now here P will get common as well as epsilon 0 will get common. Therefore this equation becomes P bar divided by capital N into P bar divided by epsilon 0, remaining term 1 divided by epsilon r minus 1 plus 1 by 3. Okay, now here PP get cancelled, the remaining equation becomes 1 divided by N divided by epsilon 0 in bracket here 3 into epsilon r minus 1, sorry, 3 plus epsilon r minus 1 divided by 3 into this epsilon r minus 1. Now this term N divided by epsilon 0 shifted towards the left side, we get the equation alpha into capital N divided by 3 epsilon 0, which is equal to 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2 divided by epsilon r minus 1. Here epsilon r plus 2, here 3 minus 1 becomes a plus 2. So we get epsilon r plus 2, and here this 3 is shifted to left side, then it will go in a denominator. So therefore final equation we get alpha n divided by 3 epsilon 0, which is equal to epsilon r minus 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2. Give equation number 4. Now this equation 4 is known as Clausius Mosotti equation. Now next point we'll discuss about the dielectric constant. Now this term dielectric constant is denoted by letter capital K. Now it is defined as, or it is the ratio of permittivity of the substance to the permittivity of the free space. free space, or we can say that permittivity of the vacuum. So mathematically, dielectric constant is written as K is equal to epsilon divided by epsilon 0, whereas this K indicates the dielectric constant. Epsilon is nothing but the permittivity of the substance. Epsilon 0 is permittivity of the free space. Now it is unitless, there is a no unit, and dimensionless quantity, there is a no dimensions. Okay, now next definition is polarizability. This polarizability term denoted by letter alpha, and it is the ratio of induced dipole moment P of an atom or molecule to the electric field E. So mathematically we can write the equation alpha is equal to P divided by capital E. Now after that we'll discuss about types of polarization. Now the polarization based on dielectric materials divided into three types. First one is the ionic polarization. Now ionic polarization is nothing but it is a mechanism that contributes to the relative permittivity of the material. This type of polarization typically occurs only in ionic crystal element such as NaCl, KCl, etc. After that, there is a no net polarization inside these materials in the absence of an external field, because the dipole moment of the negative ions are cancelled out with the positive ions, and due to this reason no net polarization will be produced inside this material. So when an external field is applied, ions becomes displaced, which leads to an induced polarization. That means when we apply the external field, then the ions becomes or get displaced, and due to this reason it results to an induced polarization. Now if we see this figure, that figure indicates the effect of an external field on an ionic material. The positive ion will flow with the field. If you see this, these are the positive ions. These are the positive ions. So this positive ion will flow with the field, and the negative charges will flow against the field. Negative charges flows against the field, okay, causing a net average dipole moment per ion to form. The equation to describe this effect is PAV is equal to alpha I into capital E, where this PAV denotes induced average dipole moment per ion pair. This alpha I indicates ionic polarizability, and this capital E is nothing but the electric field. So second type of the polarization, which is based on the dielectric, that is orientational polarization. This orientational polarization arises when there is a permanent dipole moment in the material. Now HCl and H2O have a net permanent dipole moment because charge distribution of these molecules are squid or deviate. So in the absence of an electric field, the dipole moment is cancelled out by thermal agitation, results in a net zero dipole moment per molecule. So when an electric field is applied, when we apply the electric field, then the molecule will begin to rotate to align the molecule with the field, causing a net average dipole moment per molecule. That means when we apply the electric field, then dipoles are tried to rotate with or align with the direction of the external applied field, and due to this reason what happens, it results a net average dipole moment per molecule. Now if we see this diagram, then it is observed that no electric field is applied, and when we apply the electric field, if there is a no electric field, dipoles are randomly oriented. Okay, and when we apply the electric field, then these dipoles are tried to align with the applied external field. Okay, so this figure shows how thermally agitated molecules left side can be made to produce a net dipole moment per ion in the material with an extremely applied field. Right. Okay. Third type of the polarization is electronic polarization. Now this electronic polarization occurs due to displacement of the center of negatively charged electron cloud relative to the positive nucleus of an atom by the electric field. So when an external electric field is applied, the positively charged nucleus is attracted towards the negative side of the field and the negatively charged electron cloud is shifted towards the positive ion. Now these are the figures. Now figure 1 shows atom before being placed in an electric field without applying electric field, and second figure indicates atom placed in an electric field, or we can say that when we apply the electric field. So figure 1 shows centroid of positively charged nucleus. Now this is the nucleus, okay, and negatively charged electron cloud coincide, and the negatively charged electrons are revolving around this positive nucleus. Okay, now this figure 2 shows atom when placed in an external field. If we see this figure second, here the atom is placed in an external electric field. Then from figure it is observed that the centroid of the negatively charged electron cloud moves away from the positively charged nucleus. So what happened here? When we apply the external field, this positively charged nucleus moves away from the negatively charged electron. Okay. Thank you.